for me when I was younger, I was a social butterfly, I was very comfortable with talking people, but over the years I have plenty of close friends, 5 to 6 of them, and we are having very connected. So when I go to a social gathering like this example, I don't feel like, and I don't know what to talk to people that I meet first time. Like this small talk, I kind of hate it. So any advices on that?
It's so interesting that you say that because I believe everyone is on the introversion to extroversion scale. And I also used to be very extroverted, but as I get older, the quality is much more important to me. And by the way, all those studies I mentioned about the people with stronger social connections who live longer, those social connections are deep social connections. The research on this qualifies as that people that are close enough with you that if you were in a financial bind, you could call them, or if you were homesick, they would drop food to your house. This is the level of closeness versus what a lot of us do when we're younger and we have these huge orbits of people around us. So I also, with age, have hated the small talk. And what I've realized with this is if I go in just being me, like I was goofy today, I said silly things, I spoke to you on a deeper level than maybe most speakers would bother to speak. I get a much better connection from the people who I'm meant to connect with. It's a bit like marketing. You're not meant to attract everyone, guys. So the people that don't resonate with me and think, oh, wow, there's oversharer or whatever, we're not meant to carry it on. So I don't think you should feel bad about that. Speak about the things that actually interest you. You're more likely to make a long-term real connection than pretend to be an avatar of yourself. Because otherwise, people are connecting with the avatar. And actually, one last point on the avatar-ness that I see specifically here in Asia, and I'm talking as an Asian person. I have only 9% Caucasian blood, just as another overshare for you guys. So as an Asian person, one of the things that I see with my clients is a lot of, they like to show face. So that means you feel an emotion, maybe you're really excited or you're peeved. But there's a mitigating of meaning, particularly for Asian women, because we're raised by our parents like, don't complain, don't tell too much, don't give everything away. Well, there's a lot of don'ts going on. And so we don't emote. And your face is this incredible tool, particularly in a virtual world where people can't see your body, that has not millions, thousands of micro expressions. They've all been mapped. When we don't give people that, they have much less emotional information to connect with us with. You know, if you're just giving me the I don't know face, and I'm getting that back. Well, as a human being, I want to mirror your expression because that's what my brain is wired to do. So we're not getting that connection. So please, if there's any time to push past what we've been told as Asian kids, like, don't show, why you show everyone your business, show your whole face. My mom was always like that. This is the time to give that to people. So show your expression. Don't be afraid to do that.